Demonstration of rectilinear propagation of light is given here. For doing this, take three cardboards A, B and C with fine holes at their centers. Place a lighted candle or bulb on one side and arrange the boards such that the holes are in a straight line. Viewing from the other side, you will find that light from the candle is seen only when all the three holes are in a straight line. If one of the cardboard is displaced sideways, the light is no longer seen. This clearly demonstrates that light travels in a straight line path.
Okay, a very good morning, students. Here we are with our theme 5 light chapter. In the beginning of the module, you have seen one more investigation, that is with the cardboard and the candle. In that also you have seen how the light is traveling in a straight line. In the earlier class, we have started with another investigation that was with electric bulb and a pipe. Okay, so in that also you have seen that the light travels in a straight line. That means a light propagates in a straight line. Okay, so in that case, now here we are with this, in this module we are going to learn further application of rectilinear propagation of light. Okay, now you have seen how the candle was burning and how with the inside the cardboard, how we can see the candle. Yes, with the holes of a cardboard we are watching the light, the beam of the rays what we are just falling on our eyes. You have seen. So in the application with the example, you will understand 8 such points.
Rectilinear propagation of light. Light travels in a straight line. This property of light is called rectilinear propagation of light. Formation of shadows and eclipses are the direct consequence of rectilinear propagation of light. Following are the sum of the everyday experience which suggests that light travels in a straight line. Formation of day and night suggests that light travels in a straight line. If it was not, so then the light would have curved around the earth and there would have been sunlight during night. This example satisfies the first application of rectilinear propagation of light. Let's go beyond and understand the second example where we can see rectilinear propagation of light. Formation of shadows. Now students, you must have observed in bright sunny days or even at night, when you are in an illuminated area, you see your shadow forming. Now shadow shows that you are blocking the light falling on you. Yes students, now when you block the light comes or falls on you at the back, the shadow is formed. Okay students, here we have another example. Let's see, it is the light source and the light is coming out of that light source. When it falls on any object, that can hinder its transmission. That can also hinder its propagation. What will happen? A shadow is formed. So when light could get curved, shadow was not possible. And we would have seen illumination here also. But as light cannot go curve, it can only go on straight line. That's why on hindrance a shadow is formed. So students, formation of shadow suggests that the light travels in a straight line. Let's go to another example. Now you may have observed in a dark room, let's say you have one window or one ventilation. Now whenever sunlight falls from that ventilated window, you see that the rays of light falls in a straight line. So, even by looking at the rays of light coming from a well-illuminated window in a dark room, you can tell that the light travels in a straight line. So, this example also satisfies that light travels in a straight line or propagates in a straight line. Okay, students? Here, if you have observed a vehicle moving at night, what you have seen that they use headlights to illuminate their back. That if you observe the light coming out of the headlights of the vehicle, you will observe that they are also ray which are coming out in, that is, in straight line. Yes, students? Next, move on to the candle. Now, this is an experiment that you can also perform. You can just light a candle and observe it very closely. When you will observe the candle, you will see that there are beams of light going in all the directions. But in straight line. The light is not going in curved back. It moves in a straight line. If you almost close your eyes and look at the burning candle flame, it appears as it is giving out pure beams of light. Which are traveling in which manner, students? In straight line. Okay. So, let's move and look at the another example. Now, if you have seen a lighthouse or know what is a lighthouse, it is a mechanism is used to show or help the ships in the sea to see where there is the shore and what happens at night. So that the ships not get lost at the sea. The lighthouse illuminates and gives out the rays. Now, if you observe these rays of light coming out of the lighthouse are also straight lines, which shows light travels in a straight line. Yes, students. Let's move and see one more example in your daily life. Now, students, you must have gone to theaters to see movies. When you go to theaters to see movies, you must have seen there is some light coming from the back of you. This light is the projection of the movies that you see on the screen. If you have observed or next time when you visit a movie theater, then you observe this. The light coming out of the projector is coming in straight line or not. You will observe, yes, the light coming out from the projection is coming in a straight line. Okay, students? Lastly, if you have played with toy lasers, the small lasers that are used to point at things or as a pointer itself. These lasers are examples of a very thin beam of light. Now, even in these lasers, you can observe that the light comes out is in a straight line. What this shows, students? This shows the same property of rectilinear propagation of light. So, I hope all of you understood these examples which relate the application of rectilinear propagation of light. Thank you, students.